I've seen hundreds, maybe thousands of percentage problems, and they all pretty much come down to one of three types. What is this percent of that? What percent of this is that? This is that percent of what number? We're going to work through these three different types, these three examples of these three different types, so you'll be able to tackle pretty much any percent problem that I can throw at you. We'll start with this. What is 30% of 120? We know what that of means. The of means multiply. 30% of 120 is 30% times 120. We're going to tackle this two different ways. First, we're going to turn the 30% into a fraction. 30%, percent means per hundred, so that's just 30 over 100 times 120. Knock out a common factor of 10, and we have 3/10. You can also knock out a factor of 10 between the 10 and 120, and we're left with 3 times 12, that's 36. Now, we also could have just turned the 30% into a decimal by moving the decimal point over two places, and that leaves us with 0.30 times 120. Now, I'm going to break this 120 up into a 10 and a 12 because that 10 will help wipe out the decimal point over here. That 0.30 is just 0.3 times 10 times 12. 10 times the 0.3, that just gives us 3. 3 times 12 is 36. Did the problem two different ways, got the same answer. We know we're right. We're on to the next type of percentage problem. What percent of 88 is 33? Now I can start to turn these words into an equation by throwing in a variable. We'll say x percent of 88 is 33. And now I can take this and write it as an equation. X percent of 88 means x percent times 88. Is means equals, and 33 means 33. So we have x percent of 88 is 33. We'll divide both sides by 88 to get the x percent by itself, and we'll have x percent equals 33 over 88. Knock out the common factor of 11, and we'll have x percent equals 3/8. So now we need to turn 3/8 into a percentage. Now, one way we can do that is turn a 3/8 first into a decimal, because it's very easy to turn a decimal into a percent. So I'm going to turn a 3/8 into a decimal. One way we can do that is just dividing the 8 into the 3. 8 doesn't go into 3, so I'm going to need some tenths. 8 goes into 33 times. Gives us 6 left over. Bring down another 0. 8 goes into 67 times. Leaves us 4 left over. 8 goes in to 45 times, and we have nothing left over. So 3/8 is 0.375. And we know how to turn that decimal into a percent. We just slide that decimal point two places over, and that is 37.5%. So 33 is 37.5% of 88, and we're ready for the next problem. Once again, we can start off by turning this into an equation first by throwing in a variable. 42 is 150% of x. So 150% of x, that's 150% times x is equals, and 42 is 42. 150%, we can write that as a fraction, as 150 over 100 times x is 42. We'll simplify that fraction a bit first. Take out the common factor of 50, and we'll have 3/2 times x is 42. Multiply both sides by 2/3 to knock out that 3/2, and we have 2/3 times 3/2 times x equals 2/3 times 42. 2/3 cancels with the 3/2. Take out a common factor of 3 over here. 3 goes into 42 14 times, and x is 2 times 14 is 28. So 42 is 150% of 28, And we're done. Thank you.